Hi, in this video, we'll discover what visual programming is and why you should give it a try in your classroom. Visual programming is programming with visual elements rather than solely with text. This is what textual programming looks like. This code is supposed to add one vote when I click on this button, but it's not working. Ah yes, I missed one bracket. That's why my code failed. Textual programming languages can be quite painful to learn. Fortunately, visual programming languages are often much easier. You can drag and drop elements of code without worrying about the syntax. Here I'm using RoboWunderkind's app to program a robot. Of course, your code still has to make sense. This is Kodu to create 3D animations. As you can see, visual programming languages are simple, intuitive, and fun. They are great tools to introduce kids and teens to computational thinking. All right. Now, let's have a look at one of the most used educational visual programming language. That's Scratch. All you need is a computer connected to the internet. Go to the Scratch website. You can simply look for Scratch in your favorite search engine. If English is not your preferred language, you can change it by scrolling at the bottom of the main page. To create your first project, press the Create button. Don't worry, this may happen. The online version of Scratch 2.0 runs on a piece of software called Flash. You'll have to install it, and it's free. The online Scratch editor has three main sections. This is the stage where all the animation happens. This is the block palette. The blocks are the little pieces of code you need for your program. You will drag and drop those blocks into the scripting area. Now we're going to do three things. Add a character, Scratch calls those sprites, add a nice backdrop, and make the character move and say hello. To add a character, the easiest thing to do is choose one which is already pre-made. If you want to get rid of the cat, you click right and click left on delete. To add a nice backdrop, same technique. Of course, you could upload pictures of your own. Great, let's make our character move. First, we need to specify which action or event is going to trigger the movement. Let's use a common event, when the green flag is clicked. Oops, I dragged the wrong block. No problem, I can delete it by simply dragging it back to the palette. Now let's tell the character to move. That's in the motion section. Let's choose move 10 steps and snap it with the other block. If we click on the green flag, ta-dam! Our character moves forward 10 steps. What if we say move 50 steps? Uh-oh, my character is disappearing from the stage. I can drag him back in. But I'm lazy and I don't want to do that each time. So I'll add one instruction to my code. Can you guess which? I'll use the go to block. The character will pause 1 second and then move forward. Last thing, let's make the character say something. Well, that's all for now. Oh, but wait, what happens to my work if I close my browser? Yes, it deletes everything. It's super important to save your work. To do so, you need to create or sign in into your Scratch account. Creating a Scratch account takes 5 minutes. The most difficult part is to find a username nobody already uses. I already have an account, so I'll sign in. Let's call this project EU Code Week. Now I can close my browser. If you'd like more ideas or things to do in Scratch, you'll find detailed tutorials by clicking here. And don't forget to check out my colleague's Jesus video on how to make a question and answer game with Scratch. Thanks for listening and happy scratching! Take advantage of Code Week to give it a try with your students and add your pin to the map.